Hello everyone, and welcome back to Life is Strange. Last episode, we met the one and only Chloe, and we are now back at her house. We're in her bedroom, and she's sort of just chilling in her bed, doing whatever she's doing. I think she's smoking. Yep, she's smoking. And we're now being told to put on some music, so where is the speaker and where is the CD now? It looks like the speaker's sitting over there.
It won't play without any power.
Okay. Power strip. Let's enable that. Cool, we've got power and pretty lights. Now we just need to find the CD. I believe it's sitting in... not the bin. Is it on her desk?
I think this junk swallowed her discs.
Okay, obviously not. Wouldn't be in the computer. I think it's in a container or a box or something. But I feel like the bin doesn't have it. I'll still check anyway.
Who'd have thought Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
So, nope, not in there. It's gotta be something down low on the floor, though. Can't search that box. Oh, that box.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
So, Rachel took my place. I'm glad she was there for you.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now? Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
So I guess we probably can't really talk to her again. We should probably just leave her to it. She has got a lot to think about and a lot to worry about at the moment, and all we're doing is just coming here to fix a camera.
I shouldn't bug Chloe now. Plus, I need those tools.
Hey, I wasn't going to.
Nope, someone locked it from the other side.
Thanks again, Max, for helping me. No problem, that guy is an asshole. Who are you talking about? David?
Probably David.
Yeah, that would make sense.
I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Shit! Butterfingers! Kate Marsh? Why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally weird.
Okay, now that we have seen that, I don't think we want to have those lying on the floor, because why would we want to leave evidence that we were here?
These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For real? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
Once again, we've looked at that. We're going to close that cupboard just because it's probably a good idea to look at. Oh, look at that first.
Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why.
Yeah, good idea to keep things closed. And once again, with the evidence thing, we don't want to leave a trail of where we've been. Okay, we've turned the TV off. It keeps on switching back onto my PC controls, and I don't know why. I'll just move my mouse over there, maybe.
Precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
Don't you worry, we have a solution to our problem. We're gonna push this cardboard underneath there. Washing machine back on, and should be pretty easy to reach in now. I should be sitting on that carpet. Well, it's not a carpet. It's a piece of cardboard.
Yes, you have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Like who?
Like anybody. Stop stalling, sister.
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera. I got sunburned. This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in now. Please.
1 second.
Chloe?
I'm coming!
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing! Give me a minute!
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second! My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, so...
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth, that's an order. Whose is it?
Once again, we're given two options and we're gonna try both of them. Let's start by staying hidden.
Stop treating me and my mom like we're your family platoon!
Hey! Leave Joyce out of this!
I wish you'd leave Joyce! Like now!
Chloe, I'm sorry. I care about your mother and you just keep pushing me.
Don't touch me again, asshole. That's the last time! Or I'll bring the cops in here so fast!
You're not that dumb.
I'd be smart to have you busted.
Chloe, someday you'll grow up.
Hey, you okay?
Welcome to the real step douches of Arcadia Bay.
I'm sorry.
For what? He would have been a bigger dick if he caught you in here.
That's hard to believe.
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can go to in this hick hole.
David was such a mean bastard to Chloe. What if I had stepped up to help?
That is a very good question, Max. What would have happened if she had stepped out to help? Let's find out.
Chloe?
I'm coming!
What are you doing? Chloe? Don't get smart. Just... Whose is it?
I'm sorry. That was my joint.
Well, well. I don't like strangers in my home. Especially dopers. So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do
you? Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Because you're such a badass, Max, let me show you my new toy. I'm Price. Chloe Price. Bang!
Jesus, put that thing down!
Chillax, sister. It's not even loaded. Yet.
I thought you believed in gun control.
Yes, I believe I should control the gun. It's the men who need to be checked. You trust Nathan or David? Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Yeah, I think that's a very good idea when it comes to trying to decide what decision in the game will probably lead you to the best overall or long-term outcome. I don't think this is a good decision whatsoever. Yes, you can come out and you can help Chloe, which will probably help you a bit more with Chloe later on, but David has connections to other people in this, especially people at Blackwell being the security guard, so I don't think it's a good idea to pop out and be like, yeah, drugs. Especially considering that, like he said, we also caused trouble earlier on in the day when we were helping Kate. That was a bit of a one-off thing, this is way bigger, so I'm gonna rewind and we're gonna stay hidden and just leave it at that.
Chloe?
I'm coming! And give me a minute!
Whose is it?
Damn, what are you waiting for? Open the window!
I haven't been here in forever, so why do I feel like I was just here? This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
It's really weird and spooky. This is a sign they're pointing us towards the lighthouse, which we have seen definitely in the nightmare
before. I feel like I'm in my nightmare again.
Yep, as Max continuously says, that she is reminded of the nightmare she had towards the very beginning, but we're going to head back this way because there is a cool little bird chilling over here that we can take a picture of.
I got you.
Nicely done. Bird flies away. We still got the picture of the bird. We're going to head up to the very top of the lighthouse. I believe Chloe should be sitting up there on a park bench waiting for us. Sitting there probably looking into the sunset on this beautiful evening on this fantastic hill. Sunset in the background. Heading back up onto the top of the hill. It is looking much nicer than it was in the nightmare, and we are now getting messages from Warren. We'll back later, Kay, I swear, no problem, and you have still... Well, and you still have yet to tell me your biggest secret. That's a good point. We did say to Warren...
Birds are so lucky, they can always escape.
Thanks, Max. We did say to Warren that we did have something important that we wanted to say, and we never really did because we got interrupted. Who even knows if we're actually going to get back to that? Probably not, but I guess we'll see. What a beautiful moment. Let's capture it.
Sure you don't want to be alone?
Sit down if you want.
I'm sorry I wussed out.
No worries. I know my step dork can be scary.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
Well, yeah. I couldn't help it.
Never change. What did you find?
Creepy photos of Kate Marsh. Other Blackwell students.
This dude takes his job too seriously. He still thinks he's at war or something. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
I knew you didn't know. Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
There are cameras all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the garage.
I knew it! He's so hella fucking paranoid! I'll keep this a secret for now.
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
So, what about you and Nathan?
We went to his room at Blackwell. We drank, and I laughed at his rich kid bullshit. He was one step ahead and put something in my beer.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Oh, good thing you notified the principal. I feel safer already.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
I gotta fit into the previous cutscene, like, it was not meant to be, muted or something, but in fact it was meant to be. That's why I paused the game briefly.
Is Chloe still up there? I have to find out.
Storm like this in Oregon. Oh my lord! The tornado is back! October 11th? Is this Friday? That's only 4 days away! Oh no. The tornado is headed straight for the town.
the pleasure.
And we have made it to the very end of the first episode of Life is Strange. I think I can just skip out of these credits. Now, as soon as you finish a chapter or an episode in the game, you can go back and you can review all of your choices that you ever made, the small ones and the big ones, and you can see how your choices compare to that of the other players. I believe it is specific to the platform you're playing on, so these are the PC ones. You can play it on Xbox, PlayStation, whatever platform you're on. It will probably have different things depending on the community. But for this, I seem to be in the majority for most of them, because that would make sense. It's probably most of the people that are kind of thinking about what choices could be most beneficial later on. It's just common sense, like more or less, but you'll see quite a few 50-50s, and somewhere I might be in the minority, it really depends. We reported Nathan, comforted Victoria, intervened to help Kate, and we stayed hidden. Next page. There are a lot of other smaller things that we can see in here that we did not find. The bottom one there, you didn't touch Dana's pregnancy test. 98% didn't even know that existed, pretty much. We watered the plant, which is good. I forgot about Kate's slate. I did not even know that Miss Grant had a petition. I didn't know that Daniel wanted to paint our portrait. Yes, we helped Alyssa. And yes, I'm doing this in the complete wrong order. I'm just reading them out. We didn't touch Victoria's photos, didn't write on the dirty RV. Well, we did, technically. But then we took a picture of it, and then we undid it. Apparently, we let the bird die, and I didn't even know there was a bird that was able to be killed. We didn't do anything to a snow globe, which is good. We left no evidence, because, nope, not doing that. And yes, of course, we read David's files. I get the feeling that my sound at the moment is kind of glitched, because for some strange reason, like, the captions are appearing down the bottom, but no vocals are being said. And I thought that before the nightmare happened, that was just a normal thing, but after the nightmare happened, I was fairly sure, like 90% sure or so, that you are supposed to hear Chloe and Max having a conversation there verbally. So I might investigate that before we get into the next episode, so we don't have an issue with that. Now that we've finished Life is Strange episode 1, you can see all 5 of the episodes here. Out of Time is the next one that we're going to be taking on. We're just basically going to be hitting continue, and then we're going to see where the story takes us. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Life is Strange. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.